Republican governor, and he also serves as President Trump's Secretary of Agriculture. We do have Senator Kelly Loeffler. Let's listen in.
Yes, it's going to be another late night. There are a lot of votes out there, as y'all know, and we have a path to victory, and we're staying on it. That's right. I love you guys. Thank you so much. And I want to thank each and every one of you, every phone call, every door knock, every conversation, every yard sign. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. You know, it took every single person in this room to get where we are right now. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. We got lots of things to go out, but we got some work to do here. This is a game of inches. We're going to win this election. We're going to save this country. That's right. That's right. We're going to win Georgia and save America. But you know what? It was very clear. Our election was a choice. It was a choice between the path towards socialism. You know, it was very obvious. My opponent campaigned on a platform of high taxes, socialism, government control of our health care, stopping our school choice for our children. My campaign's about saving our country, fighting for the American dream. You know, that's right. It's about this generation and future generations. So, you know, it's worth it for this election to last into tomorrow. We're going to make sure every vote is counted. That's right. Every legal vote will be counted, and I'm not going to stop working. In the morning, in fact, I'm going to be heading to Washington, D.C. to keep fighting. That's right. We're going to fight for this president. So I'm asking for every single Georgian, every single American, stay in the fight with us. We are going to keep fighting for you. This is about protecting the American dream. I'm never going to stop fighting for this country, for the American dream, for each one of you, so that every Georgian has a voice in Washington. I work for you. I don't owe anyone up there anything. We're going to get this done. God bless you. Thank you so much. God bless Georgia. We're going to get this done. Thank you.
All right, and there you were listening to Senator Kelly Loeffler there, quite optimistic despite the very, very close numbers that she is facing at the end of the night right now. She said she still sees a path to victory. She said this is a game of inches. She said it is worth it to go into tomorrow, meaning the vote tallying and the vote counting. She said every legal vote will be counted, and she said she is headed to D.C. tonight. Remember, she needs to be there for that joint session of Congress tomorrow on Capitol Hill between the Senate and the House. Because remember, she's one of the dozen Senate Republicans who have vowed to object and contest to the certifying of the Electoral College tomorrow during this joint session. So remember, we've been following this for so long here on News Now, but she said even after this very, very long night that it's almost 12:30 at night there in Atlanta, Georgia, excuse me. But she said she is heading back to D.C. to be there in the chamber tomorrow to contest the general election results for President Trump's loss there in the general election. She said she's going to be back there to fight for this president. And so it remains to be seen what that essentially will look like tomorrow in Congress and on Capitol Hill. But there you saw Senator Kelly Loeffler remaining optimistic, even though at the moment she is down by some 20 to 30,000 votes to Reverend Raphael Warnock there in the Peach State. Obviously, there is many, many more votes to be counted. So we go by the Fox News Decision Desk. They have not called this race yet. So that is what we will go on here at News Now. But just to repeat some of her points, she said she does still see a path to victory and that this is a game of inches, repeating the mantra that she's been using to criticize her opponent, Reverend Warnock, that he would bring in a radicalist socialist agenda in the U.S. Senate. And so essentially she said this America is essentially on the line. The future of America is on the line. So very, very brief remarks from Senator Kelly Loeffler. We thought we were going to get short remarks as well via video conference from Senator David Perdue. That remains to be seen. We'll be monitoring the feed for that in case he does decide to speak. At the moment, it's so close between him and John Ossoff in the state. A mere hundreds of votes is what separates them at the moment. So that's kind of how you have it right now, as we have about 35 minutes left of more live coverage here on News Now. We're going to take a quick commercial break, but you just heard Senator Kelly Loeffler say they still see an avenue and a path to victory in this Senate runoff race. So don't go anywhere. I'm Andrew Kraft. We want to thank everyone for watching. We'll see you back here in 2 minutes. And this is Andrew Kraft once again. So we're just keeping it there for a little bit more on that live bump shot, is what we call it in the industry, of the Perdue Loeffler watch party. Though remember, at this time, usually when there's not an election happening, we do like to play some of the great stories and content that our Fox affiliates put together for us throughout the day. And this is on a number of different topics, including the coronavirus vaccine, the coronavirus pandemic, exactly kind of what's going on with these Georgia Senate runoff races, just kind of a basic explainer for those watching. So usually at this point in time, we do that, and we're going to do that right now. So we're going to start off with our Chicago affiliate, Fox 32, and they did a story talking about the vaccine and an update on the progress of the rollout. So let's listen to that right now.